स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर वर्षा हुक्के, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, गवर्नमेंट विदर्भ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज अमरावती. इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द कैलस कल्चर. वी विल डिस्कस कैलस कल्चर अंडर दिस हेडिंग: डेफिनेशन ऑफ कैलस, स्टेजेस ऑफ कैलस कल्चर, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलस कल्चर, स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व इन द कैलस कल्चर, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कैलस, and finally the significance of the callus. Friends, as you know, callus culture is one of the techniques of plant tissue culture. The scientist Simon in 1908 regenerated the callus roots and the buds from the stem segment and establishes the entire process of callus culture. Now, before entering into entire process, we should know what is the exactly meaning of the callus. The callus is the undifferentiated, unorganized, proliferated mass of tissue is developed from either isolated single cell tissue or the organ. Whenever inoculated, whenever cultured aseptically on the nutrient medium under the controlled physical condition. The nutrient medium is having the macro elements, micro elements, vitamins, some proteins, and the most important is the phytohormones. That is auxin, combination of auxin and the cytokine. Most of this time there is a utilization of the 2,4-D, that is 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Now this is about the induction of callus in vitro. Sometime in nature also there is a development of callus to the entire plant. Whenever wound takes place to the plant, that is the trunk or the branches of the plant, from that area there is an initiation of parenchymatous tissue. That is, that tissue added the some, that parenchyma tissue added the tissue which is we call it as a callus or the, or it is called it as a wound callus. The main function of this wound callus to heal the injury which is expressed to the plant. Now this callus is of two types, that is compact callus and the friable callus. Compact callus means it is the cells are densely aggregated and the callus becomes the hard. Whereas in case of the friable callus, all the cells are loosely arranged and the callus is soft. From this picture, you become able to differentiate the, what is the actual meaning of the compact callus and the friable callus. Now, there are three stages of the callus culture, that is induction, proliferation and the morphogenesis. So what do you mean by induction? From the mother plant, or the process of callus culture, from the mother plant, we bring the explant into the laboratory. We inoculated this explant in the culture media. That means we have detached this explant from the mother plant and we have bring this material into the laboratory. In such a conditions, in the artificial medium under the controlled condition, first it should be established. And then it is initiation or the induction of the callus express to this explant. After it gets established properly in the laboratory condition, then there is a mass multiplication on the proliferation of that explant, and there is a development of more amount of callus with the help of the rapid cell division. And then whenever there is a rapid cell of division, more amount of callus will be formed. Now it should be going for the process of morphogenesis. That is, there is an induction of root or the induction of the shoot, and finally there is a development of the or the regeneration of the somatic branch. Now there are the, again three principles of the callus culture, that is aseptic preparation of the plant material, selection of the suitable nutrient medium, and incubation under the controlled physical condition. Now we see the first step, that is the aseptic preparation of the plant material. What do you mean by the aseptic preparation of the plant material? Whenever we bring the source material, that is explant, from the environmental condition, on the surface of this explant there is some dust, mud or the spores of microorganism present. We have to remove, we have to kill microorganism from the surface area of the explant. That is the process of surface sterilization. We will see this process detail in the next slide. Now, the next step is selection of the suitable nutrient medium. This is the most important role of nutrient medium which plays in the development of the callus culture. Mostly there is a utilization of the MS medium, that is Murashe and food medium, or sometimes the white and the gambus medium is also utilized for the production of the callus. This, as I told you, this medium is having the micro elements, micro elements and vitamins, proteins and sugar, which is the source of carbon, and the most important is the phytohormones. There is a combination of these two hormones, that is the group of hormone auxin and the cytokine. Auxin, it may be the indole acetic acid, indole butyric acid, naphthalene acetic acid, or cytokinin, that is 6-BAP, 6-benzyl adenine purine, or kinetin, or the zeaxanthin. Whenever we use this ratio, that is auxin is in more amount, that in this 2-1 or the 100:1 combination, that time there is an induction of root this explant instead of the callus. Otherwise, if you increases the more amount of cytokinin, that is 1:10 or the 100 instead of induction of the callus, there is an induction of the shoot, because auxin is responsible for the root induction, whereas cytokinin is responsible for the shoot induction. Here in this process, we don't want organogenesis, that is induction of the root or the induction of the shoot. We want the callus. In that case, we should require the intermediate combination of these two hormones, that is 1:1, auxin is 1 and the cytokinin is 1. In that case, they will induce the callus to be expand. Or otherwise, the 2,4-D, the auxin 2,4-D is gives the callus whenever we utilize this 2,4-D in the medium. This medium is agar solidified or the semi solidified. Now the third step is incubation of cultures under the controlled physical condition. We have bring the material from environmental to the laboratory. We inoculate this in the medium. Now we have to bring, we have to transfer this culture for the growth. One is source material, which is the totipotent in nature. We have provided the nutrition and the for the growth. We have provided the plant growth hormone for the cell division. Now the third requirement for the development of callus is the controlled physical condition. That means that controlled physical conditions are the controlled condition of temperature, humidity, photo period and the light intensity. We have to shape this culture in the growth room or the growth chamber where these control conditions are there. Temperature in general is the 25 ± 2 °C. Photo period is generally it is 16 hours light and 8 hours dark. But in case of callus culture, we require the total dark period. And the, in general, there is a light intensity in plant tissue culture is 2000 lux. The relative humidity we require for this room or the chamber is the 55% to 60%. Now this is about the steps involved in the callus culture. From many explant, we can develop the callus in the various plant species, but carrot is the standardized material for the callus culture. That's why we will discuss here about the callus culture from the taproot of the callus. Now our source material or explant is the taproot, which we have bring from the environmental condition into the laboratory. As I told you before, inoculating this explant on the medium, that whatever the dust particle, mud particle or the spores of microorganism which is present on the surface of the explant, we have to remove this, and that process is called it as a preparation of the aseptic medium. Now for this, whenever we bring this material into laboratory condition, first we have to wash with the running tap water. And then we will wash this with the laboratory detergent, that is the Tipol or the Labolin. And then we will give the treatment of some fungicide, that is the Bavistin. Then after Bavistin, we will rinse with the alcohol. And there are two chemicals, that is the sodium hypochlorite and HgCLD, that is mercury chloride, utilizes for the process of surface sterilization. First we will use the sodium hypochlorite, and then under the aseptic condition in the laminar aerosol, we will give the treatment of mercury chloride. That means the up to the sodium hypochlorite, the entire process of surface sterilization we will do in the washing area, whereas the from the Hg cell too, we will bring this material to the aseptic condition, that is under the laminar air flow. And remember that after each treatment, we have to wash with the distilled water, because all the traces of this chemical, whatever we have utilized for the process of surface sterilization, it should be removed from the surface of the explant. And whenever finally we will wash the material with the HgCl2, that time after the treatment of HgCl2, we have to wash the material with the sterilized distilled water. In previous stage, we will utilize only distilled water, but in final stage, we will utilize the sterile distilled water. Now, your material, that is explant, is now surface sterilized. It is free from the spores of microorganism. It is ready to inoculate. For the process of inoculated, take this explant on the sterilized filter paper, but with the sterilized forceps, blade holders or the skull spin, and take the cambium from this explant. Take the cambium along with the sterilized forceps and inoculate on the previously prepared MS medium, which is having the combination of auxin or the cytokinin or the 2,4-D. That process is called as the inoculation of the explant. Now, after the process of inoculation, you are having the cultures of the carot root. These are the cultures of the carot root. Now, to label, that is date of the inoculation, material and the medium. Now, for the production of the callus, for the initiation or the induction of the callus, the third important requirement is the growth room. You have to shift this entire callus in the growth room for the growth in the incubation, where the controlled physical condition is maintained. After some 2 to 4 weeks, there is a initiation and the development of the callus takes place. You will use this callus for the further process. This is about the steps involved in the callus culture. You can utilize this for the regeneration of the new plant or for the suspension culture. Now, callus multiplication. Once there is an initiation of the callus, after 2 to 4 weeks, they multiply 2 to 4 times. That means in a one glass vessel, that explant gives the 2 to 4 times more amount of callus. This is the first initiation of the callus. Now, you want the more amount of callus, multiplication of the callus. What you have to do, after 2 or 4 weeks, take this entire culture from the growth room to again the inoculation room, that is under the laminar airflow, and cut the pieces of this callus into 2 or 4 times and inoculate it in the previously again the same combination of the medium, that is, and entire this culture again shifted to the incubation room for the development. That means in this way you will multiply the number of callus, and that kind of culture is called as a subculture. This is the subculture one. Again, you have to give the label, that is the what is the medium and the date exact. In this way, you can go for the subculture 1, 2, 3 after 2 or 4 weeks. After entire completion, you will having the ample of callus, and that is nothing but the callus multiplication. Now, whatever the callus we have developed, it is having some properties. That is, it is often comes from the shoot whenever we go for the process of shooting. That means if our aim is to induce the shoot to the explant, that time from the cut area of that explant, which is in the contact with the medium, from that side there is an initiation of the callus takes place. And it can be maintained indefinitely, that you can multiply in vigorously or the rapidly. There is no photosynthesis and growth in the dark condition. And you can utilize this callus for the isolation of the single cell, that is the totipotent cell. Now, finally, there is a significance of the callus. Callus as such is not having the significance unless and until you should utilize this developed callus for the further process. And it is having some importance, that is, you can develop the entire plant, you can regenerate the entire plant from the callus. First, you have to take this callus and inoculate it on the medium which is having the shoot inducing hormones and the root inducing hormone, which is there is a formation of the root or the shoot to the scalene, that we call it as the organogenesis. And finally, there is the entire development of the plant, that is the process of morphogenesis. This callus is a good source of genetic variability. That means whenever we want the variations in the plant, particularly in case of the floriculture, whenever we want the different shades of the flowers, that time we will go for the callus culture. It helps to get the genetic variability in the plant. And cell suspension culture, we can initiate it from the callus culture. This callus culture is very useful to obtain the commercially important secondary metabolite. For example, if the plant is having the important secondary metabolite in the root, we can take the root as an explant. We will develop the callus in the laboratory. We will go for the process of the isolation of the single cell from this callus, which is having the capacity to develop the more amount of or the more quality, defined fine quality of the secondary metabolite. We will isolate this cell, and further we will develop the callus from this single isolated cell, which is having capability to develop the more amount of secondary metabolites. And several biochemical assays can be performed by using this callus, which whatever we have developed in the laboratory. So friends, this is all about the callus culture. Thank you. Who?